Hi everyone, I'm Khadim Ali. I'm an artist, I'm a miniature painter. I belong to a minority group, Hazaras, called Hazaras in Afghanistan. The Hazaras make 19% of the population of Afghanistan. And Hazaras have been massacred or genocide over the years, over the centuries, because they are Shia Muslims. That's also make them a minority among the Sunni Muslims. The first genocide of Hazaras started in 1890s when Amir Abdurrahman, the king of Afghanistan, killed more than 62% of Hazaras. And it was when lots of Hazaras fled Afghanistan and moved to the countries around Afghanistan. Yeah, also it was when my grandparents, they escaped Afghanistan and they went into India of those time. And after the partition of Pakistan in India, they moved to Pakistan at the border of Afghanistan with the hope that someday Afghanistan will be a free land and they'll go back and claim their land, which never happened. When my grandparents moved into India in 1890s, they had two books with them. One was, because they were Muslim, they were carrying Quran, and the other book was the Book of King. The Afghan culture was very much into storytelling, because Afghanistan is very mountainous and the weather is very harsh. They have only 3 months of agriculture, and the rest 9 months they entertain themselves with stories, with poems, things like that. So the book Shahnameh was written in 1080 in the court of Mahmud Ghaznavi in the province Ghazni of Afghanistan. And the book contains 60,000 verses in it. And in the book, the hero called Rustam, which is the symbol of the bright side of humanity. And the dark side of humanity is symbolized as a demon in the book. But my grandfather was a singer of Shahnameh. So growing up at the border of Pakistan with my grandparents, where lots of other Hazaras were coming and gathering at his place and listening to Shahnameh, where my grandfather was singing Shahnameh to them. So it was a great source of entertainment for them. But when he died, no one carried on. In that book, in the story of Shahnameh, the hero Rustam got killed, betrayed by his friend, and got killed by his own friend. But what survived in the story were those demons. It was reminding me a story of another Sufi who was traveling in 12th century from Iran into India. This Sufi, who was a poet, his name was Saadi, Sheikh Saadi. He arrived in a very cold town near the border of India. He went to the soup kitchen to get some free meal, and some barking dogs attacked him. He wanted to pick up stone to feed the dogs, but all the stones were locked into the frozen rainwater. So he took his hand up in the heaven and asked God, "What city is this, or what town is this, that all your stones are locked and all your beasts are free?" So from then onward, I felt like the Rustam was killed and all the demons are free here. And they're calling themselves Rustam. And then I started painting demons. And I kept painting demons. So I'm painting them in my medium called miniature painting. That's my style of painting. And in the Book of King, the illustration of the stories were done in miniature painting. So my encounter with miniature painting was first when I saw the illustration of the stories in the Book of King, when my grandfather was singing that. And I was looking at the illustrations. And miniature painting was first started in the Central Asia as the illustration of the stories in the book. It is miniature because there were small illustrations in the books. And first school of miniature painting was established in 16th century in one of the western cities of Afghanistan. But when Uzbek attacked Afghanistan, all of these miniatures, they escaped into Iran. So from then onward, Afghanistan were deprived of its own art medium. In 1998, I went to Iran and I did some painting courses there. And in 1999, I got scholarship at National College of Arts in Lahore, and then they were offering a degree in miniature painting, and then I found it very, like a lotto, that nothing can be better doing miniature painting as my major, because I grew up with miniature painting, looking at miniature painting.